It was a defining issue in the 2022 midterm elections as voters went to the polls throughout the country to make a statement about the Supreme Court overturning Roe versus Wade. In 2024, abortion laws will once again be in the spotlight, as well as the records of some of the GOP candidates who have themselves signed legislation as governors, but are quick to try to avoid alienating swing voters in other states like New Hampshire.
Well, look, at the end of the day, I mean, you know, we protected in Florida the rights for unborn babies that have a detectable heartbeat to be able to have a shot in life. And that was something that was right for our state. And I know other states have done it a little bit differently. I'm conscious of the diversity of opinion in the United States. New England is different than Texas. Wisconsin is different than Georgia. You know, but at the end of the day, you know, we do want to promote a culture of life. There's a variety of ways you can do that. As president, we're not going to allow taxpayer funding for abortion. And we're going to ensure that we have justices on the Supreme Court that are going to allow the political branches to deal with the issue.
Each state should make that decision. And what works in North Dakota is not going to work for New York. It's not going to work for California. It doesn't even work for Minnesota. May not work for New Hampshire. So that has to be left to the states.
As president, if a 15-week abortion ban landed on your desk, would you sign it?
Well, I think to be consistent, if you believe in state rights, you'd have to say, why is the federal government doing this? The whole point is to let states decide as opposed to trying to have a one-size-fits-all answer. So I would say no. If it's left to the states, that means it's left to the states.
And there are several other candidates who think even though states can now pass their own laws, the federal government could still play a role.
Well, first, I fully support the heartbeat bills that have been passed in places like Ohio and Georgia and Florida. But there's a bill on Capitol Hill that I think enjoys support of 70% of Americans that would establish a 15-week threshold that, again, is more in line with most Western nations, Adam. I mean, America's really an outlier on this issue, and it breaks my heart to think that our laws are more in line with China and Iran on this question than they are with most Western nations and European countries. So a minimum threshold at the national level, but I'd certainly support a heartbeat bill, a six-week bill, there or anywhere else.
They have voted in the United States Senate to have abortion on demand. Because of that, I would say as your president, I would encourage and fight for a 15-week limit of abortion in our country. I believe that life has intrinsic value without any question. I am 100% pro-life conservative with 100% pro-life voting record. I believe a 15-week limit is where the federal government should stop the radical left from pushing abortion up until the day of birth.
With more states considering legislation in the future and a possible change of leadership at the federal level, this issue will still very much be a part of the debate in 2024. In Manchester, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.